Please give a warm welcome for Mr. Tony LoBianco, please.
Thank you, Paul, and thank you very much. It's a real delight to be here. I'm greatly honored to be in the presence of a great American. God bless you, patriots. I'm supposed to speak about a few things, but I can't help myself. I'll speak about a few more. I want to start by reading a psalm, Psalm 2010. Obama is the shepherd I did not want. He leadeth me beside the still factories. He restoreth my faith in the Republican Party. He guideth me in the path of unemployment for his party's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the breadline, I shall fear no hunger, for his bailouts are with me. He has anointed my income with taxes. My expenses runneth over. Surely poverty and hard living will follow me all the days of my life, and I will live in a mortgaged home forever. I'm glad I'm an American, and I'm glad that I'm free. But I wish I was a dog and Obama was a tree. I wanted to thank Paul because when we were in Brooklyn together playing ball, softball, we were on opposite teams. And now I'm so happy to say we're on the same team, Team for America. This is something that was attributed to Abraham Lincoln, but on further account, a fellow by the name of, in 1916, I believe, might have said this, but Reagan used it, and so did the Michael Steele, so I'll use it too, attributed to Abraham Lincoln. By destroying the rich, you cannot strengthen the weak. And by weakening the strong, you cannot bring about prosperity. By discouraging thrift, you cannot lift the wage earner up by pulling the wage payer down. You cannot further the brotherhood of man by inciting class hatred. You cannot build character and courage by taking away people's initiative and independence. You cannot help people permanently by doing for them what they could and should do for themselves. Abraham Lincoln. Yeah. Let's see. Now, talking about budgets, Obama has given, I think, 3 State of the Union plans and also a budget. Now, his budget has not been passed by 99-0 in the Senate, which he controls, and failed 414-0 in the House. Now, the Senate is supposed to have passed a budget every year. They have not passed a budget in 3 or 3.5, wherever we're at now, which is rather alarming. It's supposed to be a law that people are supposed to follow. Now, we talk about deficit. We're on 16 trillion plus deficit. Does anybody know what a trillion is? 1 trillion? If you pile $100 bills, I think it's 6 feet high, next to each other, covering a whole football field, that's 1 trillion. We are 16 plus trillion in debt. That means every American and their babies, child, everyone is in debt already for $100,000. Frightening. Let's see here. No. Does it make, let's talk a little bit about what we should be doing in terms of drilling. I think when we get, hopefully, Romney as President of the United States, we will drill, we will make every effort on every gas, natural gas, everything should be done. God gave us this country. We have the riches of under our feet, and we are not doing anything about it for an idea that it might affect the environment. It's questionable whether it will affect the environment. If it does, it's going to be so minute. So what does he do? He gives Brazil $2 billion to do what? Drill. He takes oil from Saudi Arabia and other countries. They are drilling for oil. In other words, the environment doesn't go anywhere except those countries. China, where are they getting their oil from? From the ground. So the environment isn't being affected, but God forbid that it should come from this country. And the coal. We manufacture the coal here and we ship it across the country for them to burn. Not here. God forbid. We should burn coal. It's remarkable. And as you people know this thing, I am sure. You will hear more from Frank. Frank will scare the pants off you. and he's brilliant. He was in the Reagan administration, and he will tell you things that you will be wide-eyed. And pay attention to what he's saying, because it's extremely, extremely important. Now, things like voter ID. You know, there are 21 states in this country that do not, you're not required to produce an ID to vote. Doesn't make any sense, does it? You know, you need an ID to do everything else. You need an ID to get into a building in New York, of course, or anywhere else. You need an ID. You can't walk around without an ID. And even if you get stopped for a red light, you have to have an ID. You know, it doesn't to vote. The most important thing, to vote. You don't need an ID. And also, I am fed up with sanctuary cities. To me, they're harboring criminals. That's 31 cities are sanctuary cities. Does that make any sense? If you're an illegal alien and you come to this country illegal, you're breaking the law. You're a criminal. So how do you have a city that says, okay, come here, you're safe? I don't understand those things. It's a frightening situation we're in. Now let me get to what I'm supposed to talk about. Hollywood. You know, it's as baffling to me as it is to you. Remember, these are the most generous people you can find. Hollywood actors. They're always doing something for free. They're always donating their time, giving of themselves, giving of their money. They're on every telethon for every good cause in the world. You know, they're out there, give more than anybody, I think. But for them to be supporting this man is remarkable. It is unfathomable. I don't even know. You know, we could make the mistake as we have by putting this fellow in office. But tell me how the whole party follows him. Are we blind? Is it just us that we don't see? I mean, we see what's going on. We know what's going on. Why doesn't the other side see that? Every day he insults our intelligence. Every day he does something that you say, he cannot have said that. But I think that's part of the plan. Baffle you. Make you crazy in terms of, did you hear that? And dazzle you with this stuff that keeps going on and on, so you can't get up to the next day. You know, you're trying to grab a quicksilver, all this stuff. It's remarkable. The good news, as my assistant Chris Chiumbro always says to me, what's the good news you could tell us? Well, the good news is that in Hollywood, there are 2,000 actors, directors, writers, producers who believe the way we believe. 2,000. We go by the name of Friends of Abe Lincoln, and that's FOA. And there in New York, there are 500 of us. So we are trying desperately to make inroads, because there is a lot of blacklisting going on. You know, if you expose yourself, as I do, as I am, I haven't really felt it. I don't even know.
I don't even know if I felt it or not. Doesn't matter if I work anymore or not. I have gray hair. But you get to a point where you're just fed up. You know, you've got to come out and speak about it like all of you have. You know. But these people, all 2,000 of them in California, are very active, and like you are, and very active with the Tea Party, which I adore, and which I think is making a huge impact, and made a huge impact in 2010 when we took over the House. But we must take over the Senate, for sure. If we even, for God forbid, lose the presidency, we have to control both houses. And we must do everything we possibly can do to elect these fine ladies and gentlemen who are running for office. And later on, I'll tell you, I will help you in any way I can. But the baffling thing about it, it's apparently like the Jewish community, which is baffling to me that they would vote for Obama. This is an anti-Israeli human being. And it can't get more obvious than that. And we must protect our allies, especially Israel. Yeah. I have been to Israel 3 times now. I was there the last time in August. I was fortunate enough to go with the Israeli Defense Force. And we met all the generals and Netanyahu as well. We know what Israel is, how capable they are. But keep in mind, they're what, 8 million, I think? Or 7 million? Between 7 and 8 million people. Iran's got 80 million, okay? And with one of my brash statements of saying, you can't wait, you gotta go do something and so on. And what they, you know, the accidents that happen, which I'm thrilled when accidents happen in that other country that's causing all the trouble, you know, who knows, you know, sometimes things blow up, you know. Sometimes scientists disappear. Just have to be working on the bomb. I mean, that's the way you do things, I think. I mean, that's, you know, you only hope for the best. But they're a strong country. They're intelligent. It's all get out. Just for being smart, they should be supported. They're brilliant. They truly are brilliant and resilient. And the young people are just, you know, I visit all the sites. And the young people are in charge. These 21, 2-year-old kids who are adults. And you know, the great thing, and I think we should adopt some of that, is they go from high school to the military. And they become men, women. And the women are fantastic, all strong, healthy, wonderful women. And then after they finish their 2-3 years in the Army, then they go to college. You know, so look, they become pretty smart. In Israel, in the Army, because they're schooled tremendously. I watched them, 21, 22-year-olds, they're in charge. They can make the decision. They press buttons over there. They're really that reliable. And they're also encouraged to speak up. Speak up to their superiors, you know? Tell them about their ideas and so on, which I think is wonderful, wonderful. So that this fellow, the day before Netanyahu came to the United States to visit with himself, what could I have said? He had a meeting with the Muslims, and the next day he says, yes, you should go back to the 67 borders. Does he even know what the 67 borders are or where they are? I was there in August. I was at people's homes on the 67 border. I mean, beautiful, beautiful home cut right across their house. You know, and it's like cutting Israel in half. But where does he come up with? I know where he comes up with these ideas. He just had the meeting with his brotherhood. So people have got to know what is going on and really do something about this. This is a tragedy, a real tragedy. Let me see, where am I? Oh, you know, I want to segue into Frank. Before we get Frank up here, I just want to read something that the Australian Prime Minister, Julian Gillard, she spoke of Muslims who want to live under Islamic Sharia law. This is what she said, and I'm going to substitute America for Australia. Immigrants, not Americans, must adapt. Take it or leave it. I'm tired of this nation worrying about whether we are offending some individual or their culture. Since the terrorist attack on 9/11, we have experienced a surge of patriotism by the majority of Americans. This culture has been developed over two centuries of struggles, trials, and victories by millions of men and women who have sought freedom. We speak mainly English, not Spanish, Lebanese, Arabic, Chinese, Japanese, Russian, or any other language. Therefore, if you wish to become part of our society, learn the language. Now, most Americans believe in God. And this is not some Christian right-wing political push, but a fact, because Christian men and women on Christian principles founded this nation. And this is clearly documented. It is certainly appropriate to display it on the walls of our schools. And if God offends you, then I suggest you consider another part of the world to be your new home. Because God is part of our culture. We will accept your beliefs and will not question why. All we ask is that you accept ours and live in harmony and peaceful enjoyment with us. This is our country, our land, our lifestyle. And if we allow you we will allow you every opportunity to enjoy all this. But once you are done complaining, whining, and griping about our flag, our pledge, our Christian beliefs, our way of life, I highly encourage you to take advantage of one other great American freedom, the right to leave. If you aren't happy here, then leave. We didn't force you to come here. You asked to be here. So accept the country you accepted. Good. What am I doing next? Oh, yeah. LaGuardia, who's a former mayor of New York City, a three-time mayor. I'm presenting him again in October in New York. But I will go anywhere, at any time, under any circumstances, to help any candidate to do the show. It's about an hour and 20 minutes, so you can raise money for your campaign. So please get in touch with me. This is my assistant, Chris Chiembra. He has some information with him that he can pass on if you're interested. Okay, now, LaGuardia, I wrote this in the show, it's near the end of the play, and he says this: Shakespeare wrote a wonderful make-believe play he called The Tempest. It's a dream, it's a sort of a fairy story. I'm so happy I was able to dream. I once dreamed of a city called Heaven, and I tried to make it my New York. My friends, we are a nation of immigrants. And so what do we owe our ancestors for their sacrifice? Sacrifice of ourselves for others and our country. So look all around you. Look left, look right, and see your fellow man with respect, understanding, kindness, and love. And know that you are completing the dream. And when you go home tonight, I want you to think of just one thing that I said and that Frank said. And if you agree with us, act on it. Stand up and do something. My friend, you gave me a job and I did it. But now I'm asking you to carry on with patience and fortitude. And years from now, when I've long passed on, maybe one day someone will say, what this city needs is another LaGuardia. So I call on you, each and every one of you, to form the army. We need an army, not just to sit here and listen to what we're saying. Because you can hear, it goes in one ear, out the next. Because you've heard a lot of this before. Not so much what Frank's going to tell you, but I know many things that I've said to you. You've really got to get out yourself and become an army, become a general, and go out door to door and inspire the people. This is the most important election in our lives, and we all know that. So please, please, I beg you, please do your part. God bless you. And God bless the United States of America. There's a Monday night meeting at the Hyatt Hotel in New York. Every Monday, we have 5, 6, 7 candidates running for office, Republican candidates, conservatives, I hope. And they are speaking to the people, and we're getting a lot of people who come. Newt spoke there. Everybody you can imagine spoke at these meetings. But Gary Sinise, a true American hero, the actor Gary Sinise. He's done more for our troops. He's traveled maybe 7, 8 times to Iraq. He does so much for our troops here and those that are wounded. We're building homes for heroes. You can't name it, the stuff that we're doing and what Gary is doing. And he goes all over the country, no matter. I don't know how he does it because he has the lead in a television series each week, which means he's got to learn his new script every week, which is baffling. But he's out there on days off, and I don't know how he does it. But 9/11 heroes, he's there for them. He was there last week in Brooklyn, working with them. So the word is out, and it's growing. The amount of actors are coming out for the John Boyd, of course, which you all know, is one of the actors who supports this group, and you know, a terrific, terrific person. That's how we're doing. We're getting out just like you, getting out and talking to the people as much as we can. And getting our army together. Yes?
Who are some of the people in Friends of Abraham?
Well, there's a lot of good actors. They may not. It's believe me, we're under the radar. There's a lot of actors who do not want to be mentioned, come out and deal with that because you get blacklisted. I mean, it's like in the old times. Yes, sir? Someone raised their hand.
Hey, yes. Mr. LoBianco. I too come from Brooklyn. I was born in the streets of Brooklyn, as are you. What's really mind-boggling to me, you look at Hollywood, these are very intelligent, successful people. This country put them in a position to achieve things beyond anyone's wildest dreams. Why is it that they feel so committed to form big government when it's within their reach, if they choose,
they can write a check. They can start nonprofits that would be far more effective in utilizing donations to reach the people who are less fortunate.
You're asking the same question we all are. It's not just the actors, it's the whole party. It's the people that put this man in office and making the election even after 3.5 years of demonstration of who he is, what he's doing. He has the backing that the race for presidency is close. So how do you explain that? Whether it's the actors or whoever the people, the people. We've changed our country drastically from within, and it's a slow takeover underneath our country that's been going on for a number of years, and we're in that state right now, and we've got to fight for our lives. Anybody else? Quickly, okay.
The Friends of Abraham, are they open to the public?
No. The Friends of Abe is just for actors, directors, writers, and producers. You know, it's a theatrical branch. But let me let, if there's any other questions, because I'll get a whole bunch of questions later if you want to talk. But let me, okay, yes.
Do you mind sending us that, giving us that song that you did at the beginning? Spread that around. Yeah. Yeah.
I'll tell you what I'm going to do. Whoever wants to have it, please give your card and your email to Chris, and he will email you that poem, that song. Okay? Sure. Absolutely.
It'll be on YouTube.
It'll be on YouTube? Yes.
It'll be on YouTube.
Okay. But you want a copy? He wants a copy of it.
Yep.
All right.